Hello, Commanders. Welcome to the command table. I am Mathermar, and we're going to be going through SR15, SR12, and SR1 Wicker Colossus. So hopefully that covers most of the bases to show you what you can do in each of those different brackets. Before we get too far ahead, though, if you would please be so kind as to like, subscribe, and if you want notifications when I drop new videos, be sure to hit that notification bell. Also, if you have any comments or questions, or if you've got a clever raid strategy, feel free to leave that below and we'll take a peek. Alright, so we're going to go over some of the more important things to note. The first thing to note, all player units start with negative 95% of max health. Now, that's going to be different depending on your star level, and that affects multiple things. You need to be very concerned about which power stones you're using. Given that at SR15 and SR12, it crosses that 50% threshold, the Berserk is going to be the ideal choice because you're going to get 150% bonus damage per stone. So you'll notice on this one set of Warhounds, I have two of them, that's 300% damage. You compare that to 15% for a total of 30, that's 10 times the bonus damage. So if you have the Berserk Stones, it's definitely worth equipping them first on your Warhounds until you run out. If you have extra after that, then I would definitely go to the Wraiths. As you'll notice, I've just got the one because I ran out. And if you have any left beyond that, then feel free to toss them on your Plaguebearers or your Direwolves, whatever you happen to be using at the time. So I'm going to show you the several setups that I have using those different units, but I wanted to cover the power stone thing first. So first thing you do, click that wounded modifier. If it's below 50%, then it's worth using Berserk. If it's not, you're not going to get any benefit at all from the Berserk power stone. It's going to be a completely wasted slot. At that point, it is worth using the attack to, or yeah, damage to, sorry. So damage to would be the ideal choice if that modifier doesn't get you below 50. Now that's another thing to consider when you're looking at your artifacts. For the Ring of Unity, it's just time-based. So that's going to be a regular cycle of giving you damage no matter what. If you look at the Amulet of the Panther Queen, you're going to have to see what your rank is, because that's going to tell you right here, 40%. So depending on what star rating you're on and what that wounded modifier gives, that's going to tell you whether or not it's worth using this at all. The results from a level 3 Ring of Unity and a level 3 Amulet of the Panther Queen are very comparable, as you'll see. But if your SR doesn't get you below that threshold, this is totally useless. It'll just give you a little run speed boost, and that's about all you're going to get out of it. So pay attention to that. Make sure that you double check that wounded modifier. The enhanced range doesn't do anything. Boss isn't attacking anybody, so you don't have to worry about that at all. The other artifact you want to be using, other artifacts that you want to be using, Primal Warhorn. You want to stack as many units on the battlefield as you can. Sometimes it's a toss-up between using Direwolves or Plaguebearers, because the Plaguebearers will buff your horn by adding to the number of the count. And the Direwolves do have a really stout buff for your nature units. And if you're putting all of your Berserk Power Stones on your nature units, then you definitely should consider that as well. I've had pretty comparable results using Direwolves and Plaguebearers, so just have to figure out what works best for you depending on your unit levels. Okay, so that covers most of the basics. You'll notice up here for elixirs, I am using the time elixir. I've found that it gets awful close right towards the end there for me. So just adding that extra safety net. I'd rather spend 15 gems on this elixir than 40 gems on a premium raid key. So it's just worth doing. If you just need to get that extra edge, you can also throw the power elixir on there as well. And that might put you over the top. So it's really just an economy issue, and that's totally relative to the units that you have, to the artifacts that you have. You've just got to find out what's worth it to you. If you can do it with no elixirs and two keys, that may be a different story than using two elixirs and having to end up using two keys anyway because your spear didn't hit. So, you know, you do whatever's safest you think, or whatever you feel comfortable risking. But for me, if it's within 2 seconds of hitting that target and I'm not getting the spear procs, it's going to cost me an extra key. I might as well just use that one elixir and make all the difference. Oh, and I have done some testing on this. The if you do just need one elixir to make the difference, the time elixir is the better of the two. Power elixir, yes, it does give you 25% boost to damage, but that's only 25% for 30 seconds, whereas you're getting 100% of your normal damage for an extra 10 seconds, which is a 33% addition to your damage. So I prefer time, and not to mention when you use time and you're using spear, you do get more chances for the spear procs to land. So that's something that you also want to consider. Okay, so that was very lengthy, but just wanted to make sure we covered all the basics. Let's pop over and show you the results. Here was my first couple of SR15 attempts. I threw the power elixir on there just to make sure that I got it. You'll notice that I'm using the amulet of the Panther Queen instead of the ring. And I get, as I mentioned earlier, pretty comparable results. Just because if I had another, 9 Berserk stones, then the Ring of Unity would be the clear choice, because I could stack it on all of these wraiths that you see camping in the back there. And you can put 2 on each of them. So the Ring of Unity would get a lot more damage out of those wraiths. But since I have just enough to cover all of my Warhounds and only one wraith, that is just, it's going to be about even across the board. So that's, again, another thing for you to consider depending on what resources you have available. Oh, let's rewind this one. Okay, this one I have the Dire Wolves instead of the Plaguebearers. At least I think that's the difference here. So again, pretty straightforward. Just goes all the way through, and you'll notice that I get to 0. Where does I get to 0? Okay, just like 2 or 3 seconds. So the spear procs do make the difference. If you miss more than you hit, then you're probably going to need to throw on an elixir somewhere. Okay, this is where I switched to the Ring of Unity, and now I'm back to the Plague Bearers. Something that one of my clanmates, he's actually taking some time off right now, hell, a very smart dude. He discovered this trick here. We notice these Plague Bearers. Watch this. Watch these Warhounds. Okay, they're getting pushed around once those Plague Bearers arrive. So now all these ones that are kind of jumping up and down, more of those are getting spread in to where they're able to reach. On the top and the bottom, it's even more so. So that's one of the huge benefits about the Plague Bearers, is that they have the mass and the push to be able to wrap stuff around and push it through those units and make sure all those Warhounds are hitting. So even if the Dire Wolves do have a better buff for your Warhounds, the Plague Bearers make it to where your more of your Warhounds are actually hitting the boss. Okay, so here was the last one, just testing again, switching Dire Wolves and the... Now we're Dire Wolves and Ring of Unity. So we've kind of done all 4 combinations between the Amulet of the Panther Queen, the Ring of Unity, the Dire Wolves, and the Plague Bearers. We've kind of tried some of each, and they all end up in about that same area. It's either 20 to 21 million. And I know that's way overkill. Again, I didn't need both elixirs for all of these, but I just wanted to... I thought it was worth expending them just to demonstrate, yes, it is comparable and pretty static. He was asking about resources. I had to give him a suggestion on that. Okay, so here's where I just removed it to the removed the power elixir, and now we're just down to time. And you'll notice that once we get to 10 seconds, that's where I would have ran out of elixir. If I didn't have the elixir, that's where I would have ran out. So 1 second, boom, I would have barely had that before it ended. So if I don't get the spear procs, I'm going to end up spending an extra premium key, And if that happens every three times, I might as well just use an elixir and not have to worry about it. Okay, so that's SR15. We'll show you the SR12. Okay, so I did it with elixirs. And that went fairly well. Excuse me. So with elixirs, went way over. Totally didn't have to be concerned. You'll notice is right there. Where are you? Yeah, okay, boom. So 19 seconds left with the time elixir. I would have had 9 seconds left without them. So then I switched over and just did it without elixirs. And that's just the analysis you're going to have to do. I think it's safer to start with the elixirs on your first attempt and then kind of discern, okay, I got it done with 8 or 9 seconds left. I can drop at least one elixir and then see how you do from there to see if you're getting it done with 10 seconds to spare using the time elixir on a consistent basis. You could drop that too and save yourself some elixirs. Okay, so there it goes. Totally got that with 3 seconds to spare. So let's go ahead and move on. We'll show you the SR1 attempt for those of you who are at lower levels. The trick with this, and again, notice no modifiers, nothing to be concerned about there. You don't have to worry about Berserk. The damage power stone is going to be the clear choice. What you want to do is you want to stack as many Warhounds as you can. And you don't have to worry so much about what level they are. Honestly, it's better to have two groups of level 3 Warhounds than one group of level 8 assassins. So I would level up my Warhounds pretty evenly across the board till you get all of them to level 8. And then I would focus on getting a couple to level 12 from that point. And then you may get them to level 10. And then get start leveling them up to 12 from there. But I would at least get them all to level 8 first, then get 2 or 3 of them to level 10, then I would get 2 or 3 of them to level 12. So that's SR1. So thank you for watching. Again, please do like and subscribe. And check out thecommandtable.com, where we have tutorials, we have raid strategies, and in the near future, we'll add some merch and a comic strip. So thanks for watching. We'll have more for you soon.